edges to help us create perfectly perpendicular lines. And we're going to learn what that means once we draw it. I'm going to start. With a what? Yes.
Line.
A line. I'm going to start with a line. And I'm going to just decide. I'm going to like maybe look towards the center of my line, I guess, as best I can. And I'm going to just pick a random point on my line and call it X. You want to call this point X? We might need to go earlier in the alphabet.
A. Point A.
Should we start with A? Okay, we're going to start with point A on our line. I would like for you all to go ahead and draw yourself a line and pick a point A close to the center of your line. Give yourself space from the top, so maybe go a little bit farther down. That's a good amount of space. Same on one side as we did on the other. Yeah, it's the same distance on one side as it's on the other. It's the exact same distance. Now, let's go ahead and let's put our compasses down carefully, and we're going to put a point on our hash, and we can call that point B. And we'll put another point on our other hash, and we'll call it
C.
So now we're going to open up our compasses a little bit wider.
Jump it. Jump it wider. Like this one. This one.
So now we're actually going to use point B, and I'm kind of going at an angle. I'm looking at A, and I'm just going to make a hash out in space where it looks like it would line up with A, making sure my needle point is on. Yep, a hash out in space where it looks like it might line up with A. And then I'm going to do the same with C. I'm going to put my needle point on C, and I'm going to just kind of draw an X in that hash. So I had two hash marks making an X. It might not line up perfectly with A. That's okay. That's not what we're trying to do. Now, keeping my compass the exact distance it is right now, I'm going to do that up here, too. Keeping my needle point on B, I'm going to make a hash in space on the other side of my line where it looks like A. And I'll put my needle point on C, and then I will cross that. You see how I made two X's with my hash marks on the top and the bottom? Let's go ahead and let's, in the middle of that X, let's make a point, and we can call that point D on the top. And then on the bottom, we'll put a point D. Now we're going to set our compasses down. We're going to pick up our straight edge. We're going to use the metal side of our straight edge. We're going to line up these two points. It's okay if it's not perfect with A. We're going to line up D and E. And we're going to connect D and E. And then pull your straight edge away and see what you've done. What did we do with our lines? Tell me what you see. Yes.
We made an X.
We made an X. What do you notice about the position of these two lines?
It's perfect.
What's the position of the line BC? What's the position in space? It's a straight line, that's for sure. What's its position, though? Do you remember what its position is called?
Horizontal.
Say that one more time.
Horizontal.
Horizontal. Now tell me what the position of line D is. It's a vertical. So, is it slightly off to the side? No, it's perfectly vertical. So, same with B and C, it's perfectly horizontal. When you have a perfectly vertical line that intersects with a perfectly horizontal line, we call that a perpendicular line. Can you say perpendicular?
Perpendicular.
We just made perfectly perpendicular lines. We used one line to create, what kind of a line was this? this again? This is a horizontal. We used our horizontal line to create a perfectly vertical line that intersects it. We call these perpendicular lines. My friends, I would like you to try this one more time on your own. Down on your page, I would like for you to come up with a line. However you want to label it. And remember that we always start with a point somewhere in the middle, right? A point somewhere in the middle.